shout out to my boy Kenny. He's talking about side characters in this video. Side characters that we need inside of Marvel Spider-Man 2. Let's get into this shit. Let's bring it back. Let's go ahead and bring it back.
Hey everyone, CBK here to bring you another Marvel Spider-Man 2 video. What else is new? It's all I talk about on my channel. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, then be sure to subscribe to the channel to keep up with all of the Marvel Spider-Man 2 wishlist videos, leaks, rumors, theories, and more. So in today's video, I wanted to talk about side characters that I would like to see appear or have a role within Marvel Spider-Man
2. It's my belief
that at the core of every Spider-Man story is Peter Parker's relationship with the people around him.
Right.
So the side characters have always been important for every Spider-Man story. If you don't have a relationship that's believable, or just a relationship that the viewer or player doesn't care for, then it's hard for the user to become invested in that relationship.
That's a fact. Bro, that's a fact. If you don't got no characters, even if they're side characters, if you don't got no characters that you don't present in a certain way that gives you a certain feel towards them, bro, fucking raps. You would not give a fuck about that character at any time. At all, bro. Like, that's a fact, bro. I'm sorry. I know this just from knowing it. You know what I'm saying? Let's get back to it.
First story there may be between Peter and said character. And so far, I think Insomnia Games has done a fantastic job with all of the side characters in their games.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, aside from, like, Screwball, of course. But today, I would like
Screwball
to go over what additional...
And them MJ missions. Except for that rooftop one, or the penthouse ones.
Side penthouse characters one. I would like to see Insomniac introduce and build on within Marvel Spider-Man 2. So with all that being said, let's hop right into my list of characters I want to see in Spider-Man 2. So first up, we have a fan favorite character that has kinda sorta already been introduced, and that is J. Jonah Jameson.
Right.
We do have the award-winning podcast to listen to, and we did get that
lit.
Small little tease of J. Jonah Jameson within Spider-Man Miles Morales. However, I would like to see a more physical presence of J. Jonah Jameson in Spider-Man 2. Jameson
right.
is just an iconic character and a fan favorite. Perhaps J. Jonah Jameson could go back to the Bugle, or maybe Spider-Man just happens to have more run-ins with him within the story.
Right.
I don't really care how it's done. I just want to see more of him in this game. I feel like they perfectly casted that character in this game. I'm not sure who the voice actor is, but he's phenomenal. I mean, he represents the purest form of J. Jonah Jameson, and I love him in this game. So I'd love to see a much more expanded role for him within the game, and possibly see him more physically throughout the story. So next up...
Bro, imagine, because like in the comics, obviously, Spider-Man, J. Jonah Jameson, they're always doing shit like... It's always some shit, bro. It's always some shit. I'm talking about face-to-face type shit. Like, Tombstone was hella cool, unexpected villain. I was not expecting to fight him. That's a fact. That nigga Tombstone got them hands, too. Big motherfucker. Well, on the game. On the game.
I want to see Eddie Brock introduced in this game. We already know
we
got to
see Eddie Brock. The only way they could reveal Eddie Brock is if they really threw out the game. Really build his character up to the point where we start giving a fuck. If they could do that, we are good.
The universe, and Peter and Eddie already have a history, but I would like to see that personally explored for myself.
Right. There are
rumors out there that Insomniac could be
That'd
making
be amazing.
A solo Venom game. If these rumors are true, which I can't confirm that they are, but if they were to be true, I could see a scenario where the symbiote makes its way from Harry to Eddie.
Oh, yeah.
Eddie would be the perfect character to carry a solo Venom game. That is,
fact.
If they decide to take the Lethal Protector route as opposed to him being a straight-up villain. There are a ton of characters out there that have a history with Peter or Spider-Man in
too many of them
that we haven't got to see explored, and Eddie is among the top characters that I would like to see represented in this game. Next up, we have another character that has been mentioned within Marvel Spider-Man before, and that is Flash Thompson. I don't need a large role from Flash Thompson, but an appearance would be pretty nice, just to see what he's up to these days. Based on the small Easter egg in Marvel Spider-Man, it looks like Flash Thompson has been doing something to help with the homeless. So it would appear that Flash has moved on from being that childhood bully figure and is now helping people at this stage of his life. There is also a very, very, very small possibility for an Agent Venom storyline down the road. This
yeah.
is
I don't see that happening in any way.
Story where Flash Thompson gets the symbiote and becomes Agent Venom. I don't think it's likely that this would happen, but it would be pretty cool if it were to happen. And the best way of making that happen is by introducing Flash Thompson. So I don't really have any expectations for him getting the symbiote, but it would still be cool to see Flash Thompson. So next up, we have the one and only Gwen Stacy.
Yep.
Listen, I don't care what anyone says. Gwen Stacy is
one. What's the difference between anti-villain and superhero? Anti-villains don't give a fuck. Or anti-heroes is what you probably meant. Niggas don't care, bro. They in between.
One of my favorite characters in the Spider-Man universe. And I'm not even saying that MJ needs to die for Gwen to show up so she could be a love interest for Peter. I'm fine with just a small cameo just to establish that she is in this universe. Insomniac Games did respond to a tweet regarding Gwen being dead in their universe by saying, "Who says she's dead?" So my hope is that she is alive and well in this universe. Besides, if Gwen had already died in this universe, I'm fairly certain that there would have been some sort of mention of it in the first game. I wouldn't even mind if Insomniac took the Spider-Verse approach by making her the same age as Miles and possibly a love interest for him. I just want to see her eventually. And heck, maybe even down the line we get a Spider-Gwen game years down the road.
Eddie was always Venom, so just don't see that. It's gonna be someone who disrespect. Think about that for real. Yeah.
Who knows? So that is my list of characters I would like to see in Marvel Spider-Man 2. Please do leave your list in the comments down below so we can discuss. Also, feel free to check out some of my recent videos I've done. I did do an in-depth review of Spider-Man Remastered, and I think it turned out pretty good, so check that out. But with all of that said, I'm going to go ahead and head out, and I'll see you guys next time.
Ah! I'm bad, y'all. I'm dozing off a little bit. Anyway, oh shit.
We begin with a basic kick.
Now, of course I played Gran Turismo 7. I got that for I got a review code for Gran Turismo 7 actually.